Oh yeah, thanks, Nate. I think I'm gonna go with that. I used to have one. They're nice and they're thick. Really good mice. Look how generous they are. Look how generous they are. Are you sure you don't want to stay, Ivy? This is a really good gacha. And it's also like one of the best gacha. It's not abusive of people's time. It's actually good. It's the best gacha you could possibly experience. But I understand your personal reasons and I support them. I'm just saying. The only reason I play it so much is because it doesn't feel like other gacha. And the story's actually good. And it's a visual novel. Kind of. Oh, you wish you could. I understand. I understand. That's all you need to say. I respect that. How does it... I'll show you how it plays in terms of combat. Good night. Garlic bread. What do you mean, garlic bread? This game is so good, Nate. No, I don't really love garlic bread. Oh, hey, Bodhi. I really liked it. I liked it a lot. Also, don't at me. I know that what they did here was wrong and I need to switch. But now I'm out of garlic makes me gag, Kowalski. It's very strange. Garlic makes me like dry heave a little bit. It's very bizarre. It's very depressing as an Italian. God, Fur Knight is truly the best music. Free research. Oh, you, oh my God. I fucking love this game, dude. I need to get those two, though. Yum. Watanabe. I'll show it. It's free, first of all, just so you know. You don't have to spend any money or anything. And if you play it every day, kind of like you would Destiny, you can get this character for free. Alright, let's do some dailies. She's pretty hot. Yeah, I know.
Thank you.
Oh. I know. Finally, they're doing marketing. I posted that on Twitter today. I was so excited. Cry Mocking? No, I haven't. Honestly, Butters, the game is pretty fucking good too. Hey, Jolly. Yes, unknown. How are you? Nice to have you in. Yeah, the music does go hard. The music goes very hard. It should be Nicole, yes. It plays similarly to Honkai, yeah, but I think I like it better. I think the art style will grow on you, Butters. You think it's not optimized for PC? It feels great to me. I see no issue with the ping system. ~120? Oh my god, okay. I did see that. I don't know how I feel about it just yet. I've never played Rosetta. Speaking of Virgil,
you're right.
I don't know. I actually prefer it. I prefer the number. I prefer numbers. Like, I have no problem with the number system. I think it needs to be reworked for PC, personally. But that's preference, obviously. Now this is taking a little long. This is the ping system, so you want to match colors. So essentially, like you see, I've got two yellow, so I'm gonna use blue and then I'm gonna use red, and hopefully I get the next one I get is yellow. Yeah, and then that's a more strong attack. So now I'm gonna hope for another blue. There you go, and then that does a specific damage attack. I failed. Yeah. That makes sense. Alright, well, whatever. Let's just do some Phantom Pain Cage. I'll do this. After Selena, who's my favorite character? Bianca Stigmata, 1,000,000%. There are some scythe waifu, yeah, one in particular. Oh, Tsuki! Isla. What's up, Seven Ox? How you doing? Welcome into the chat. The real problem, though, is that Hikma being the, what's it called? Actually, let's just dive into the story. Do I want to get a higher S tier, Bianca? Or is she okay at a single S? Double S? Of course. Gotcha strikes again. Oh wait, I might have enough. Where is it? Four and six, right? Five and six, okay. See ya, Nate. Thanks for hanging out. Hey, Adris, how are ya? Damn it. Thank you. sorry, for now, I'll just leave that as is. Oof, not good. Okay. All right. Oh, you know what? What was the permanent mode they just added? They added like a new mode that's permanent. Do I want to voice act in PGR? Yeah, my really good friend Sura is Alpha and Lucia. Nice. Oh, you know what I also want to do, I think, is I want to do the tutorial stuff. Nice.
Hi.
She said hi. Also, PGR is the only game that actually sat down and celebrated my birthday with me. That's how I celebrated my birthday, by playing PGR. PGR was so nice to me. It was a whole story quest for my birthday. Damn. Could have really used that. All right. It is very wholesome. Oh, Selena's in here? Wait. Oh, I didn't realize that. Man, that double S Garnet, it was such a good call. I think it's a, is it triple S? No, it's double.
Oh,
Okay. All right. Also, this claim all button that they added, what, two patches ago was such a lifesaver. Look at all those black cards. Six, you said? Yeah, six. Okay, for the record, I didn't sleep enough, so I'll push and see how much I can do of this. If I start to get sleepy, because I literally like got 4 hours of sleep, I will pause and we'll keep doing it next week. But I think I should be all right. But the problem is the reading gets me sleepy, so. All right, here we go. Oh shit, this is Lamia stuff. I know, of course, that Plato's Atlantis never really existed. Oh, and also I probably won't read out loud because I have a coaching at 5:30, so I want to make sure that I save my voice. So in case it's just quiet, it's just because I'm reading. Oh, you know what? Can you give me 5 seconds? Hold on. I need to send a script to my coach. 1 second. I'm so sorry. I'm still here. All right. Oh, it's Collins again. Yeah, the drone is not great. The drone is very meditative. Sometimes too, like a fault, actually. Butters, I moved in April. You must have just forgot. Yeah, Collins is definitely a piece of shit. What was my preferred class? Dexterity, always. Damn, that was dense as fuck. Ooh. Nearly put me to sleep there. Yo, Vera is so cool. The redheaded death. I love that. Especially because he's not in her garnet form yet, or her garnet coating. Her garnet robot. What's it called? Construct? Frame. Duh. Yeah, I think she does too. It's interesting how Kurono, they're like ready to kill. It's all unique. I don't necessarily like the mission theme, but like this theme is incredible for building tension. Hey Sith, how are you? Damn. She's such a badass. Vera. Hey, Hysteria. What's wrong? Did I make you piss your pants? Why are you here? This is... I'm just chewing gum so I can stay awake. I don't remember Rebecca. She's new? Okay. Mm. Guys, I'm going to make popcorn. I was saying, sorry, I need to make my popcorn because otherwise I'm gonna fall asleep. It feels like Vera's like helping us out. Then again, she is that support staff, right? So. Only the start is a bit wordy. Mm. What exactly is going on? Thanks. No, leave it. Leave it. Leave it. Leave it. Okay, Vera, easy. What's RDF? You won't. How about those on yours? Oh, recitativa di Fontaine. Oh. Enough with that expression, it's repulsive. God, they love using narwhal. The chat engine? Whoa. Vern's mysterious island cannot hold a candle to this floating fortress, even if it were real. Yeah, I really like it. But this is technically like the right way to read, because when you're hearing dialogue and then it goes this slowly, it's like oof. Ah, that was the beginning of the chapter. Okay, so it's all taking place on this island. Jump. Don't worry, Hal won't spoil it. He knows. Oh my god, we got to ride with Vera. I can't wait for Surviving Lucium. The construct's artificial skin is way more sensitive to airflow and wind direction. Their reaction and response speed is also unrivaled by humans. Controlling the steering toggles, Vera guides the two of you to the landing pad slowly and precisely. The city was impressive when you observed it from up high in distance. As you descend, its shapes become clearer and clearer. It is like an amalgamation of a fortress, a pyramid, a city, and a mountain range, but it is also so much more. There is nothing in real life that can compare to its majesty and mystery. It looks more like a myth realized by humans with science and technology, a legend that has come alive. Atlantis, resting upon the Atlantic Ocean. Like the lost city in those stories, it is a ruin without a sign of life. There is no activity you can detect here. No sound, light, electromagnetic wave, radiation, heat signature, nothing. Far to the east, dark, menacing thunderclouds are headed towards you. They block the sun with their enormous mass and cast a giant shadow where you are. A better metaphor appears in your head. A grave. It is a grave on the sea. Huh? Whoa. When your feet finally touch the ground, you feel a sense of relief. Vera releases your straps the moment you land. She ties the strings of the parachute to her waist and swiftly dives into the ocean, swimming towards the red beacon. With her impressive strength, she ties the crate that is twice her size with a string soon after before pulling it up onto the landing pad. The crate is an airdrop capsule with the logo of the world government printed outside. You are familiar with it. Supply crates like this were airdropped from Babylonia back when you were fighting on the surface. Except this one has a few characters laser engraved underneath the world government logo. Garnet. What does that mean? Oh, shit! Oh my god, cool! Vera operates the identification interface that opens the crate for a while before turning to you, frowning. Walk up. Vera's brows relax. Guess you aren't a complete moron. Only commandants have the authority to open airdrop capsules with higher clearance. Put your face to the interface. You complete the retina scan and confirm your identity. With the sound of gears turning, the supply crate opens up from the middle, its covers unfolding to the sides. A frame that looks identical to Vera's appears before you. Is this your backup frame? Vera does not answer you. She just stares at her other self in silence. It lies quietly within the crate like a blade in its sheath or a rose frozen in time, except each of its petals is stained with blood. An unmanned frame is a non-living thing after all, but the lack of humanity is what makes it appear even more beautiful and deadly. Well, we're using this frame, huh? How generous of you, Chief Commander. She walks to the frame, her hands on the capsule, her head lowered. All her usual sharp edges seem to vanish at this moment. Looking at the frame, she has shades of her past reflected in her eyes. Except that past does not seem to contain any good memories. Shrouded all over her is a more dreadful sentiment. Vera's red hair drapes down, tangled with the red hair of the lifeless construct in the capsule. And then... Are you going to keep staring when I change? She looks at you from the corner of her eyes, her gaze and tone playful. Oh, getting shy, are we? How adorable. I don't mind you looking. Jesus, Vera, fuck. Moments later, it's done. You turn around. You find Vera in her new frame, holding her original one horizontally. What seems to be peculiar seen originally is strangely beautiful in a way. Vera places her original frame back into the capsule and stretches. Fuck yeah, there she is. There's the queen. The frame is well adjusted. I should be able to continue this mission right away. I know, but she's like, she's flirting. Obviously not. Would I be able to adjust to it so quickly if it was new? Let me get my popcorn. Nicola's gaze in the recording lens directly on Vera as she has anticipated her standing right in front of him. Kurono's run by Collins, right? And that new girl, Rebecca, is that her name? And they're trying to oust Hassan? This is where the glistening era ended and the dark age of the punishing virus started. That's right. The city you're standing in was once a zero-point reactor. Whoa. All right, let me get my popcorn. She loves popcorn. Oh my god. Chat, today we're on a walk and I didn't have any treats. This bitch, there was a dead squashed frog. She grabbed it, shoved it in her mouth, and I had to be like, I was wearing like, you know, like a fucking, I look like a yuppie in my vest. Oh, there you go, Luna. You all fell. And I was like, Luna, no! No! That's so funny. You just called Luna this bitch. She is technically a bitch. No, I never call her that. I don't actually call her that. I love her. She's my little cuddle bug. Where does the song A Dentist play? Oh. Seems that way. What are you gonna do?
Mmm.
Wow. That's what she's scared of? Right. It's funny how rude she is. I really love the descriptions in the text. This is way before Punishing Virus, right? Am I a Twitch partner? Yes. She really is a tsundere. Yeah, for sure. The near vibes are so crazy. Whoa. I haven't played the English dub enough to know. Oh my god, wait, what a second. Wait a second. Is Lamia that woman?
time to eliminate the threats. I await your orders, Commandant.
You know, I always thought it was Commandant, not Commandant. That's kind of weird.
song echoes through the future we wish.
God, Bianca's so fucking cool, dude. Insane. Like, I feel like I'm missing something, but I don't care, because, like, it's just so slick. What's Ultima Awaken mean? Does that mean all the way? Oh my god, no, Magma. Did you get triple S? S plus? Damn. How does she play up there? Is it a significant difference? Hey, Muramasa, how are you? I think my days of dropping $300 on games are over. Tsugi, stop! My double S Garnet was one of the best investments I've ever made in this game. And the good news is that we're so far behind global that, like, buying some of these characters makes a ton of sense, and it's viable for a long time. You know what I mean? Because, like, after Bianca, after Stigmata, I'll pull Alpha, Crimson Alpha, or whatever she's named. And then I probably won't pull Tolamia. Because I looked up everybody else. Thank you. Thanks for priming it up, Mushroom. Someone else quickly gift sub. Someone sub to the channel really quick so we can hear that again. How'd you know that was a yawn? Two patches? I thought it was next patch. Man, I love how Vera's so fucking pissed right now. Hold on, I want to see this. So, oh yeah, it's in two patches. The next patch is a new character. And then it looks like the what's number 21 here? Oh wait, hey Nade, yeah, Bambinata's next. So this is Lamia. Blazing Sepulchrum. Who's this? Cradle Parade? Oh no, that's BRS. I don't know who that is. So all I'm saying is that it's oh, Alyssa. So I feel like, okay, yeah, so I'm not gonna pull for Renaissance Le Fantastique. Oh, but she's free, so that's cool. I won't pull for Lee. Definitely pulling for Wintry Shackles here. I won't pull, this looks like, what's her name? I won't pull for this looks like Noctis? Another Noctis? A different Noctis? I could see myself pulling for a Pulau. Yeah, Pulau, sorry. I could see myself pulling A rank. Oh, whatever. I could see myself pulling for Ensnarled here. Feral Scent. I don't know what she does. Known. Okay, that's right. Definitely, Lamia is a must. Anyway, all that to say, I feel zero guilt dropping some money. I feel zero guilt. These three are the big ones for me. This I could take or leave, but I bet you I'll pull for Feral Scent. But these three were... Stigmata was a must-have. So, in my mind, it there was no compromising that. So, and the gameplay proved it. I mean, I'll have to see how they play, but in general, he does look cool, but... how are you going to compete against... Look at this. I mean, you can't. You can't compete. And then, yeah, so anyway. All right. It's not I know you're being funny, but it's not about waifu versus males. I don't really care about meta, that's for sure. I just want, well, like, I want cool gameplay. Like, I don't even care if it doesn't fit the team structure. Yeah, I mean, it's a giant motorcycle, isn't it? And this is the last chapter with Hidden. I could see they're already kind of doing away with it a little bit as we shift into seeing Lamia's perspective too, so that's cool. Oh, 16, okay. Has no more hidden chapters. So this is clearly one of, I think this is Lamia. Because why else would Lamia be trying to come back? And this whole chapter is about Lamia, so. Do you consider Punishing Grey Raven, chat, a visual novel? I mean, it might as well be, right? The Bible. Oh god, the word count puts the Bible to shame. If you like visual novels, hold on, sorry. If you like visual novels, I've heard, granted it was from a, it was from an employee at Square, but I heard that, what's it called? Actually, I really want to play it because it seems like spooky, but like not too bad. What's it called? It's called, but I've heard great things about it. Yeah, it's a like a horror game. It's Paranormasite. Speaking of graphic novels, Paranormasite apparently is very good here. So, like, you like, it's like, I don't know. If you like graphic novels, you might like this. Seems like it's extremely well done. Anyway. Yeah, it's pretty good. I don't know how you stream a graphic novel, a visual novel, I should say. I assume people read it out loud. I'd love to read this out loud, but... Oh my god, what? What are you doing? Yeah, no, it's a legitimate... It's like about bringing back somebody from the dead, I guess. And there are a couple of jump scares, but it's like the scope of it, it's horror based. I really want to play it. It's only 13 hours? Ooh, perfect. Vera feels like an Aries. Is Umineko on Steam, by the way? Isn't there a Guts visual novel too? Hey Avalon, how are you doing, first time chatter? Are you lurking? I've heard so much about the Umineko soundtrack, I kind of just want to buy it and play it. A 100 hours? Hey, Osa. Damn, that's longer than, Cyberpunk, which I need to start playing. Wait, L, Lustrous, Lamia? Thank you. I'll pick it up, actually. It's very gory. Oh my god. Wow, this is right at ground zero, huh? Holy shit. Are you ever going to do a genocide on Undertale? No. My time with Undertale is over. Damn, that's a lot of pressure on a person, huh? But I thought it happened in the first reactor. Isn't the first reactor in Atlantis? Oh. They were isolated. Jesus, she's rough.
levels.
This chick, this girl, this is Bianca Stigmata. I'd say pretty good. She's level S. Yep, it's definitely Lamia. Damn. Hold on. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Which one is evolution effect? Is so you're saying that crit rate increased by 20%. Activate sword form with more than half afterglow points left. Will grant each hit of a basic attack and afterglow attack to sword form 2 bonus stacks of stigmata. Oh, we'll now stack up to 99 times. Right now it gets stuck around 45. Basic attack, sword dance generates twice the signature energy. Immediately gains a random set of 3 ping. Signature Bright Castle Candle will record a 100% multiplier of the signal orbs pinged in core passive, glowing lantern-like cast in luminous realm. Then unleash an attack dealing this multiplier physical damage to all the units. I don't really understand this language. This damage cannot be critical and immediately grants Bianca. Oh wow. Stigmata 30 stacks of Stigmata will when basic attack sword dance attack. How many do I need? All right, chat. Unfortunately, I have to go. If you're gonna pull her one more time, then I think I'll pull her one more time. I'll pull her one more time so that she's viable like indefinitely, so the power creep is a little bit delayed. Chat, I don't know that I'll stream later tonight. I'm feeling kind of tired from waking up so early, so I probably won't be on to stream. I really want to keep pushing through this chapter though. My god, it's so good. I'm liking learning about Lamia's backstory here. But if not, definitely next week. Hey, Sosian, yeah, the VOD will be up. Well, you can watch it on Twitch, or you can also, Marco Meepo VODs will have it up eventually, probably next week. Either way, I'll talk to everybody later, and have a great rest of your night or day or whatever time it is over there, okay? See you.